Hello there, this is Mr. Echo 58, and welcome to a new game called Dear Esther. After all the other games I've been playing, the horror and the action games, I thought it'd be nice to bring something at a more slower pace. Dear Esther is a first-person exploration game developed by the Chinese Room. Chinese Room also did other game and Amnesia. It's won some BAFTA Games Awards for the best Brit game. It's a pure story-driven experience, and was originally released on PC back in 2012. Anyway, let's get into it, find out what it's all about. Can't do anything about the music, I'm afraid. I can't turn that down.
Dear Esther, I've lost track of how long I've been here and how many visits I have made overall. Certainly the landmarks are now so familiar to me that I have to remind myself to actually see the forms and shapes in front of me. I could stumble blind across these rocks, the edges of these precipices, without fear of missing my step and plummeting down to sea. Besides, I've always considered that if one is to fall, it is critical to keep one's eyes firmly open.
Let's get into it. Well, the state of those toilets. Out of here too. Nope, not a thing. Let's keep going. Get up here, hills and stuff. There's to be a way around that way. I kind of miss doing these little series like Firewatch, what I did last year. Slow pace, but for me, a lot of fun.
At night, you can see the lights sometimes from a passing tanker or trawler. From up on the cliffs, they are mundane. But down here, they fugue into ambiguity. For instance, I cannot readily tell if they belong above or below the waves. The distinction now seems banal. Why not everything and all at once? There's nothing better to do here than indulge in contradictions whilst waiting for the fabric of life to unravel.
This guy's deep. He's finding himself, I think.
Hello.
hope he's wrapped warm.
A wonderful sight. The moon cresting the junction between the cliff path and the stone circle. It cast a shadow of the ridge across the beach, all the world as if you had signed your name in untidy handwriting.
How did he know my handwriting's untidy? Who told him? I want to know. There's a beacon up ahead, I believe.
When someone had died or was dying, or was so ill they gave up what little hope they could sacrifice, they cut parallel lines into the cliff, exposing the white chalk beneath. You could see that old man parting the cliffs with his arms. No gifts or Bibles laid out on the sand for the taking. No tides turning or the shrieking gulls overhead. The bones of the hermit are no longer laid out for the taking. I have stolen them away to the guts of this island, where the passages all run to black, and where we can light each other's faces by their strange luminescence.
Sounds like this guy's writing a novel about his experience. I wonder if there's any other people around here.
Did he vanish too? Why, asked the farmers. Why, asked Jacobson. Why bother with your visions at all, if you're just to throw your arms up at the cliff and let it close in behind you and seal you into the belly of the island, a museum shut to all but the most devoted?
What are these things? These symbols and the like. It'll have a meaning, but to find out what. Let's get out of here. I think I'm on the right track. I don't know about him, but if I was up here in these ledges, I know I'd definitely fall.
I've become convinced I'm not alone here. Even though I'm equally sure it is simply a delusion brought upon by circumstance. I do not, for instance, remember where I found the candles, or why I took it upon myself to light such a strange pathway. Perhaps it is only for those who are bound to follow.
Maybe. these stones, I wonder. So many questions, not enough answers. Too early in the game, I guess. Like it's becoming night really soon. Find out.
Dear Esther, I have now driven the stretch of the M5 between Exeter and Bristol over 21 times. But although I have all the reports and all the witnesses and have cross-referenced them within a millimeter using my ordnance survey maps, I simply cannot find the location. You'd think there would be marks to serve as some evidence. It's somewhere between the turnoff for Sanford and the welcome break services. But although I can always see it in my rearview mirror, I have as yet been unable to pull ashore.
Words you lost. There was not another opening anywhere here, was there? Pretty much stuck there. That's not the path to take.
An imagined answer phone message. The tires are flat, the wheel spins loosely, and the brake fluid has run like ink over this map, staining the landmarks and rendering the coastline mute, compromised. Where you saw galaxies, I saw only bruises cut into the cliff by my lack of sobriety.
This guy's a poet and he didn't know it. To look at and get on any of those ships. Like all the effects of a noise in the background. Atmospheric noise. certainly all alone, that's for sure. Can we get up on here? Cannot go any further. Buttons I can interact with, climb or anything like that. My options are limited. See any way onto that boat. Onwards and forwards we go. Find a good path to get back up. Can I? Nope, I cannot. I can walk a bit more faster than this.
I had kidney stones and you visited me in the hospital. After the operation, when I was still half submerged in anesthetic, your outline and your speech both blurred. Now my stones have grown into an island and made their escape, and you have been rendered opaque by the car of a drunk.
Sure, my character has a story to tell. What was his mysterious past, I wonder?
I've begun my ascent on the green slope of the western side. I've looked deep into the mountain from the shaft and understood that I must go up and then find the way under. I will stash the last vestiges of my civilization in the stone walls and work deeper from there. I'm drawn by the aerial and the cliff edge. There is some form of rebirth waiting for me there.
Up and under, you say? Rebirth, really? You're the person making the etchings across this island.
The Bothy was constructed originally in the early 1700s. By then, shepherding had formalized into a career. The first habitual shepherd was a man called Jakobsen, from a lineage of migratory Scandinavians. He was not considered a man of breeding by the mainlanders. He came here every summer whilst building the Bothy, hoping eventually that becoming a man of property would secure him a wife and a lineage. Donnelly records that it did not work. He caught some disease from his malcontented goats and died 2 years after completing it. There was no one to carve off lines onto the cliff for him either.
Breathing. Lower class, was he, or something?
My heart is lamp.
What snobs?
These false dawns waking into the still never light. I sweat for you in the small hours and wrap my blankets into a mass. I have always heard the waves break on these lost shores, always the gulls forgotten. I can lift this bottle to my ear, and all there ever is for me is this Hebridean music.
We hear you. Through the back. Maybe not. Oh, look in here. All of his symbols. Rebirth, etc. Need to find out more of his storyline. Know what's really going on. I won't fall. Ah!
Come back.
So you can die. So much about him having a firm footing. Okay. Looking down the ledges is dangerous. It will kill me. This path is dangerous.
Jakobsen's ribcage, they told Donnelly, was deformed, the result of some birth defect or perhaps a traumatic injury as a child. Brittle and overblown it was, and desperately light. Perhaps it was this that finally did for him, unable to contain the shattering of his heart. In half-light, his skeleton a discarded prop, a false and calcified seabird.
Is this not where I started? Maybe not. Don't know. Mind you, I'd get lost just going around my own home.
They found Jakobsen in early spring. The thaw had only just come. Even though he'd been dead nearly 7 months, his body had been frozen right down to the nerves and curled into a claw right under the winter moon.
Hello.
Even the animals shunned his corpse. The mainlanders thought to bring it home unlucky. Donnelly claims they dragged it to the caves to thaw out and rot, but he is proving an unreliable witness.
What happened to Jakobsen? He died. Why didn't no one go looking for him? Did he have no neighbors?
Climbing down to the caves, I slipped and fell and have injured my leg. I think the femur is broken. It is clearly infected. The skin has turned a bright, tight pink, and the pain is crashing in on waves. Winter tides against my shoreline, drowning out the ache of my stones. I struggled back to the bothy to rest, But it has become clear that there is only one way this is likely to end. The medical supplies I looted from the trawler have suddenly found their purpose. They will keep me lucid for my final ascent.
So my character is affected by the decisions I make in this game.
From here, this last time, I have understood there is no turning back. The torch is failing along with my resolve. And hear the singing
that ain't good. That ain't good.
Passages above me, and they are promising the return of the gulls.
Okay, people, I'm going to leave it here. I hope you've enjoyed this little sidetracking from the games I normally play. And if you think this is something this you might be interested in watching on my channel, let me know. This is Echo 58 signing off for now. Later.